Mount emergency physician and ABC News medical contributor Dr. Darian Sutton joins me now for more on this. Dr. Sutton, good morning. You know, we saw a huge surge in cases after people gathered for the holidays. How worried are you that we could see a rise again due to people gathering to watch the game?
Good morning, Diane. I have exceptional concern. From what we know, the surges in COVID-19 have occurred via social gatherings. And what I like to remind my patients is that COVID-19 likes social gatherings as much as we do, especially indoor gatherings. So I do have exceptional concern when it comes to the Super Bowl this coming Sunday.
And the NFL gave more than 7,000 healthcare workers free tickets to the game. It's the first time we've seen an event with such a large group of people who have been vaccinated. So what should we expect? Are these people still going to be wearing masks? Will they still be socially distanced? What do you expect?
Yes, I think that they should and will be wearing masks and still and should be socially distanced. From what we know about the vaccines that are currently being utilized, that's the Moderna vaccine and the Pfizer vaccine, we understand that this vaccine decreases rates of death, hospitalization, and symptomatic COVID-19. However, the data simply isn't there about transmission from person to person. And what we like to assume is that if the vaccine makes it less likely to be symptomatic for COVID-19, therefore there likely is a less likelihood of transmission from person to person, but that's really just an assumption. And right now, we just have to act on data and not theory.
All right, so just because you're not going to get sick from COVID-19 doesn't mean you can't spread the coronavirus. We'll still have to wait for more data on that. In the meantime, Johnson & Johnson is requesting emergency use authorization for its vaccine. What would that approval do for the rollout effort, especially since this vaccine only needs one dose and doesn't have those same ultra-cold storage requirements that we saw with the Pfizer and somewhat with the Moderna vaccine?
It would be an incredible asset. The Johnson & Johnson vaccine, from what we know, is up to 85% effective in preventing symptomatic and hospitalization COVID-19, and then up to 100% effective in preventing death. And so I think that if we were able to add the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, it would be an incredible asset to the rollout of the vaccine overall. Right now, the CDC has reported that we are dispensing approximately 1.3 million vaccines a day. So far, approximately 27.9 Americans have been vaccinated, and 6.9 Americans have gotten two full doses. And if we stay on that trajectory with just Moderna and Pfizer, we'll have about half the American people vaccinated by this summer. But if we add in Johnson & Johnson, we can increase that rate and possibly have more people vaccinated at an earlier time.
And what's the timeline on this? When could we see the J&J vaccine approved?
So the meeting for the approval via the FDA is reported supposed to happen the end of February. And then results happen relatively quickly after that, as we saw with Moderna and Pfizer. I believe those meetings happened on Fridays, and we saw approvals as early as Monday. And then Johnson & Johnson is stating that they would be, if having emergency use authorization, they would have availability of their vaccine by March. So we could see this very soon.
Lots of fingers crossed there. There are also some new studies now looking at the possibility of vaccinating children. What are we learning there?
This is something that we're still waiting to get more information on. As Dr. Fauci had stated in last week's press briefing regarding COVID-19 response, we're doing de-escalation studies, which means that they take participants who are under the age of 18 and 16 and basically give the vaccine and test for safety and immunogenicity, which means whether or not these patients are developing an appropriate antibody response. And as time goes on, we'll start to learn more and making sure that this vaccine is safe and effective for patients under the age of 16 and 18.
All right, Dr. Darian Sutton, it's always great to have you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.